Hey everybody, it's Melissa. I wanted to share my latest project that I've been working on. I finally finished it, and I'm gonna go as fast as I can, and I'm gonna apologize ahead of time. I'm very tired. My daughter's shower is today, and I have been running around like crazy for the last 2 weeks. So and I had to stay up late last night to finish this book, but it was worth it because she's great. So anyway, I made this for her to be able to put pictures and memories and whatever from the shower. So I used the Jenny Bolin classic red and black stack, and it lent itself perfect because it's red and black, obviously. And also, my daughter doesn't know it, but we're surprising her. Her theme that she doesn't know about is Alice in Wonderland. It's her favorite movie when she was little, and she still loves it, don't we all? Anyway, I used that paper. I used black chipboard. I used grunge paper on the cover here. And the way I got that beautiful, and I hope y'all can see it, it's got glimmer mist and ink, and it almost looks like suede. In fact, it really does look like suede. And the way I achieved that, I used black soot ink first, and then went back with the slate glimmer mist, and it is absolutely gorgeous. I wish y'all could see how pretty it is. I love the way it came out, so I'll be using that technique again. And I used Tim Holtz on the edge die throughout the book. I used several different ones, forgive me if I don't name them. And then this is a Martha Stewart punch. I just punched both sides to make the rosette shape. I believe it's a Jenny Bolin calendar. If I'm mistaken, I apologize. And then, of course, a Tim Holtz bingo chip, the number 23 for the date today. And these are the Tim Holtz mini rosettes. And on this one, I pulled it to make it oval shape instead of round. And a Fiskars punch and stamp. And then a Jolie's Boutique sticker. And this is the actual medallion that we're using on the favors for the wedding. And these are her colors, cream and black with a touch of celery green. And this is their monogram. So this book is not real intricate because Lexi's not into that. And so I did it kind of plain. My sister, being the sweet thing that she is, hey Carrie, thank you. She let me use these Crafty Secrets stamps that she ordered. And it really made the book. The book wouldn't be an Alice in Wonderland book without it. So anyway, just a large tag. This is a piece of October afternoon graph paper, and I used the stamps to make medallions for the top. This back here is a little note that I wrote her, and then the date. Look at the Mad Hatter. Isn't he funny? So I did that, and then this is another Tim Holtz on the edge die, and I used the heavy chipboard that I used for the covers for that. On this page, I took the Cheshire Cat and stamped it on the chipboard. I mean, stamped it and punched it out and then put it on a piece of that heavy chipboard. And that's what holds this closed when it's down in there. Just made a journaling spot. And then on here, I took one of the stamps and just cut it up into pieces and made little banners and made a gatefold photo mat. This is I believe it's a recollection stamp from Michaels, and just cut that out. And it closes like that. And then this is just another stamp, and I made more banners. It says, let's have some fun. The first tag, the tags are very plain and very big for her to do a lot of journaling. She loves to write. And I found the Seven Gypsies tags to do this with. And they lent themselves perfect to this book. So this is they. I mean, it even has the little suit of cards and the Harlequin shape. It just was perfect. And then the Oh Dear stamp from the collection. Now I left the back plain for big pictures. And on this one, this is one of the Queen's royal servants with his royal summons, and then the stamp up here. And I did use a little bit of color. I'm not a Copic marker colorer. My hands shake too badly, but my daughter did get me these I think they're Copics, the sparkly markers for one of my birthday gifts. So I do use those. As you can see on this one with the rabbit, says I'm late, I'm late, I'm late, and then the little clock that I fussy cut. I did put a little bit of color in there. I don't know if y'all can see it or not, but it does have color. A little bit of blue and a little bit of gold. And there's a close-up on that. So the next page is the queen. She's fabulous. Love her. And I just cut her out and put a little color on her. And I had this big red heart bling that fit perfect right there. And then made a banner. Oops, shadow. Made a banner and used the little tiny types from October Afternoon, put off with her head. And this is another of the Recollections, or the Paper Studio paper, not Recollections, from Hobby Lobby. And I love this stamp of Alice. This is after she's defeated the queen. And I put a little color on her, and a little bow out of seam binding up here, and Martha Stewart corners. And this is just a flap. I made a little journaling spot to go in there. This is on the edge die. And so is this. This is the full die, and it's out of that heavy chipboard. And I just made another, cut another one out and modified it so that it sits down in there. Makes a nice little double border. And then Tweedledee and Tweedledum, and I left this one just black and white. I love the pen and ink stamps. Love them, love them. This is just a really old frame, a Sizzix frame. And I do have the embossing folder that matches this pattern. So I embossed it and put a little bit of, I think it's Moonlight ink on there, so you could see the embossing a little bit better, which I don't think you can really. But I can. And this is just a journaling spot back here. This is a wooden stamp that I ordered off eBay that has the Queen and Alice on it. And just put journaling lines on the back, a little bit of seam binding at the top of the tag. And then, remember the scene painting the roses red? Well, we had to have that in there for sure. So I had this little white rose that I painted with Candy Apple Glimmer Mist, and then I put, you can see how shiny it is, I put glossy accents on top to make it look drippy. And then on the frame, behind the frame, I have crafting plastic. Can't do anything without crafting plastic. And this is an EK Success Border Punch. And the tag on this one is just plain. It says, it's all fun and games at the top. And that was already on there. And this is just a pocket for her to slide pictures, or she can write or whatever and put notes there, or she can save cards and put there from the gifts. And this tag is just plain. I did absolutely nothing to this one. It just has that wonderful crown on it. And I stamped this. I can't tell you what collection the stamps are from, but I did get them at Michael's. And put just a piece of seam binding behind it. And popped it up on black pop dots. And this is my favorite, I think. I used the Sizzix, the little postage stamp frames, and some crafting plastic. And then behind the frames, I put the queen and then her cards. And it says, it's all fun and games until the queen arrives. And I forgot to make a tag to go back here. This is a pocket for a tag, so I need to do that soon. So. And then the last two pages, the tag, I made this particular tag just with some stamps that I had. And this is one of those dollar stamps from Michael's. And the back is blank for large pictures, as I said. And just a very large photo mat. And I'm hoping to get the bridesmaids together at the shower and maybe put that one there. And then I have an Inkadigadoo wedding stamp. Wedding dress stamp, and I just cut that out and popped it up. And then the rectangle on the back is in that embossing folder that matches this paper. Let's see if I can get see. Maybe you can see a little bit there. And this is just some trim that I have. I had gotten in my scrapbook store a long time ago. And this mat is some graph paper that I printed out. And a stamp of Alice when she's big picking up the king. And then just stamped some crowns here. And this is another stamp from the same collection as that, this one. And it says, life, memories, happiness, family, remember, laughter, and fun. And this is a dollar spot stamp also. And then the Cheshire Cat again on the back of this one. And then I have another one of the on the edge dies here in the heavy chipboard. So I hope I've covered everything. I know I went kind of quick. And I apologize for that, but I've got to get moving. But I hope y'all like it, and I hope everyone has a wonderful week. Thanks for watching. Bye.